Welcome, everybody, and happy new year. And let's just hope it's a mighty year of victory for the light. I truly do feel that it is going to be just the most marvelous year. And now we're just going to start, as we always do, this wonderful opportunity of opening our hearts and just sending love, light, and deep gratitude to all life on our earth and the great ascended ones in our I Am presence. Let's take some slow, deep breaths to get into that peaceful, receptive state. So we breathe in slowly and deeply. We hold our breath. We breathe out. And then we hold our breath. Let's do that for a few more breaths. Now let's listen for our heartbeat. Our heartbeat, which is a pulse of light coming down through the silver cord from our mighty I Am presence, anchoring in our heart, giving us life. Let's just see and feel and bless that heartbeat. That heartbeat that anchors into that beautiful 3-4 flame, which is the anchorage of our mighty I Am presence within our physical bodies. Let's just connect with that beautiful flame as we sit in that expanded golden flame in the center, golden yellow flame of wisdom and illumination, perception and discrimination. We see our bodies in this beautiful, dazzling golden flame. To the right, we can see the pink flame, that glorious, dazzling pink flame of pure divine love. And then we see to the left of us that beautiful expanded flame, that sapphire blue, bringing into us the feeling of the will, the power, the faith, and the protection from our mighty I Am presence. See and feel and bless this glorious light. Let's take our awareness now up through the top of our head, through the silver cord, to our mighty, beloved I Am presence. Let's see this glorious, all-powerful, all-knowing, all-loving presence smiling down on us. Our wonderful presence of God, I Am. And now we see in the center of our chest a beautiful golden sun forming, dazzling and brilliant like the noonday sun, the beautiful focus of light from our I Am presence. Open our hearts and send love and gratitude to our mighty I Am presence for beating our heart and giving us life. And now we see those rays from our beautiful sun in the center of our chest, dazzling and brilliant, billions and billions of rays going forth and connecting up with each and every miniature sun in all the cells of our bodies, our 4 earthly bodies, all those little inner workers receiving this expanded light. Let's feel the joy, the happiness, and the gratitude of each and every little inner worker of our 4 earthly bodies. Sense and see and feel that wonderful light saturating our earthly bodies. And now let's just fill our feelings with a feeling of love and gratitude And let's call to the beloved Ascended Masters, the beloved Ascended Master David Lloyd, the great God of Gratitude, to fill us, each one and all mankind, with this feeling, that light substance from the Ascended Master realm of gratitude and love. We see our beautiful suns turning a deep shade of pink with a golden radiance. Gratitude and love for all our many, many blessings. Gratitude and love to the great Ascended Hosts for these marvelous teachings. Gratitude and love for all our loved ones and our friends. Gratitude and love for our homes and our supply. Gratitude and love for all the many, many blessings that we receive daily on our earthly journeys. Gratitude to the great and beloved elemental kingdom, animate and so-called inanimate, the beauty and bounty of nature. God bless, love and thank them, each and every precious one. Gratitude to the beloved angels. And gratitude to all life on our beloved earth. And now we see these rays in this wonderful expanded state, forming a lattice of light, dazzling and brilliant. We see our entire earth folded in this glorious pink and golden light, saturating every part of life on our beloved earth, especially those parts of life that are never loved or thanked, with this wonderful gift, our opportunity of sending love, light, and gratitude to all life. And we just give deep, deep thanks for this. And so we do, so grateful. And Jenna Smith, have you got a screen, beloved? Are you able to do the opening invocation for us?
I can indeed. Yes, I would love to. Good morning, everybody, and Happy New Year. So before reading the words of the Master, we say together with our mics muted, as suggested by beloved Lord Tiptumi. Beloved presence of God, I am. It is thy life and intelligence that enables me to read and comprehend and absorb that which is required of me. For life, I am so grateful. Beloved Master Kathumi, I ask your feeling and your capacity to use this instruction for God's glory and mankind's comfort. And we thank you so much. And now, great I Am presence, take me within thyself. There, instruct me and cause me to retain the full memory of these inner instructions. And we thank you from beloved Saint Germain. God bless you all.
Marvelous. That was so beautifully read with so much feeling. Thank you so much, beloved Jenna. Right, so here we are, New Year's Day, and John, bless his heart, he recorded for us just some gems, as always, from beloved Ascended Master Bob, and just reiterating over and over these things that we just need to constantly remind ourselves on as we journey here on Earth. And then I've got the video. It just sort of came to me that get ready. Actually, it's get ready. Your help will be needed. And I thought, so I'd play that one again. I know we've played it before, but I think it was actually a long time ago. And it's just a really good one to keep also being reminded of. And then, beloved, Terry's going to read DWAL's New Year Address and the Need for Compassionate Love. And it was just lovely. It's a short one because the video is a little bit longer. And then I'm going to read from beloved God Lemoray, God of Harmony, because I just felt it's just so critical now to have harmony and to do our very, very best to maintain that harmony in our lives and our worlds and our feelings all the time. So it's just nice to listen to beloved God Lemoray. And then beloved Antoinette will take us through our decrees, that wonderful opportunity we have to send the light out to the earth where it's so greatly needed. So now we're going to listen to beloved John reading Bob's discourse.
Discourse by beloved Ascended Master Bob. I Am Discourses, Volume 12, Discourse 4. Try to understand this one particular point. Make a note of it to keep you reminded. Anytime something confronts you that would create a disturbance of some kind, instantly remember your presence is the power instantly on God that will prevent it, that will dissolve cause, effect, and record of that. If it has come from some past condition in your experience, then that activity will instantly dissolve and consume it. And if it be from some outside condition, then the power of the presence will repel it. I want you to realize, if you will tonight, that year is a point of discord. Over year is a point of harmony. When your attention is there, pointing to point of discord, you are accepting the discord that is there. All you need to do is change your attention over here to the point where the power of happiness and perfection is, and instantly you are absorbing, accepting into your world, the outpouring of that happiness. And why? Because here at this point of discord is but human creation, and it has no power except the life that individuals feed into it by their attention. Over here is the power of happiness, which is eternal, the light of God that never fails. Its power is an ever-increasing activity and is the authority of light. That is the difference, beloved one, between putting your attention on something limiting and discordant, or over here on the power of the presence, which holds all perfection and all power of activity within your human form, to accept a condition or reject one you do not want. You are the choosers in your world, beloved ones, of how this energy shall act. Oh, if you continue to allow your attention to go from one point to another, how are you going to direct that energy in constructive power of action? Now remember, precious ones, it is not difficult. You can look at that wall, or you can look at this wall. There is not anything in the world that can prevent it. Then if your attention has in an unguarded moment become fixed upon limiting discordant things, turn it to the presence and say to the discord, you have no power there. In your decrees, when a body of individuals like this tonight, I was watching definitely for the action when you said the human creation and repeated it three times, you have no power. My dear ones, could you have seen that activity tonight? You would know definitely that when you declare that with intense feeling, shall I tell you what has been released into action for the students the first time tonight? I may not give you the full explanation. It will no doubt be given during the class. There are a great many people who do not get sufficient feeling into their call for the use of the violet consuming flame. Now then, you are going to have assistance whether you want it or not. Whatever the cosmic light has chosen to do, I cannot at this time give you the explanation of. But I tell you, dear ones, remember, as this radiance grows greater, people with destructive motives won't stay long. Now I tell you, dear hearts, this is no idle thing. This power of the violet consuming flame is going into action with tremendous power, in addition to your call. And as I have called your attention to it tonight, please, every time you call your I Am presence into action to use it, remember, and you do not need to know why it is so, but just accept that you are having the intensified assistance of that. how do you suppose the great divine director dissolves the remainder of your human creation? By the use of the violet consuming flame, of course. When they have seen the great earnestness among the students, and yet so many not understanding, and I mean by that, they have not stood guard sufficiently over their own feelings to detect what is acting, so that they accept things in their feelings, and the things that disturb them and make them feel their application is not energized enough or strong enough to produce the results. That is not the case. There is not one of you in this room that could not produce gigantic results at your core. But you would have to keep out of your feeling all questioning of it.
Marvelously read, beloved John. Thank you so much. And just so beautifully put by beloved Ascended Master Bob. God bless him forever. All right. So now we're going to listen to beloved Saint Germain speaking about our help is needed and how we need to be ready. And hopefully we are getting more and more ready as days go by. This is an instruction from beloved Saint Germain from the Bridge to Freedom Journal's Book 3. Be ready, your help will be needed. Through the coming of great world changes, we come into strange days now, when great numbers of people may be in distress. They will need your calls to set into action the transmuting powers of the violet fire, which you have been prepared to call forth. Bless your dear hearts. You are now, and have been for many years, through your devotion to my violet flame, transmuting much more discordantly qualified energy than you know, much that does not even belong to yourselves. So straighten your shoulders, raise your head in the dignity of gods and goddesses of freedom, realizing that if the so-called sinister force does make an inroad into your world, emotionally, mentally, etherically, or physically, it may not necessarily be your own. It is just destructively qualified energy coming into the violet fire for redemption. Let us learn to live above the tensions which plague the consciousness of the people of the world. There is no way for you to survive as a spiritual movement or even as a spiritual group if you live below what I have chosen to call the waterline, where there is fear, all sorts of distress, intolerance, hate, anger, rebellion, and jealousy. If you do, you are then a part of the mass creation and the mass mind. You are in the bottom of the pit of human creation. Instead of dropping a rope, our instruction to those below you, by which you can raise them by their acceptance out of the darkness of human iniquity into the light of God that never fails. In the great cities, you have a tremendous opportunity to raise and free life, because of the very pressures of so many millions of life streams living there. Nearly all come with one desire within their hearts, and that is to find expression for their particular talents and their particular developed momentums, or through proximity to great numbers of people to earn their living. These millions of souls all gathered know very little, if anything, of the law of mercy and compassion, and know practically nothing of the activities of the seventh ray. So in these cities, countries, and nations all over the world, where there are those fortunate life streams who know of the sacred fire and how to call its violet flame into action, these have the joy, responsibility, and opportunity of setting their fellow man free through its use. Never limit your presence. Now, as the beloved Mary said to you recently, and it cannot be repeated too often, do not limit the powers of your I Am presence. Please, beloved ones, become reacquainted with that glorious presence, which I choose to call the magic presence, because of its wonderful omnipotent power and its willingness to act to and through you at all times. Personally, you could not possibly even attempt to rehabilitate the entire human race
the 7.5 billion who are already in embodiment, besides those billions who are awaiting physical embodiment here, and all those who have been released who are now working out their salvation in the various temples and spheres at inner levels. No, of course not, but your presence can. Your infinite individualized I Am presence has sustained you for eons of time. Then, as was described to you some time ago by the Lord Maitreya, when the outer consciousness voluntarily disconnected itself from the conscious contact with the I Am presence continued in graciousness and kindness to keep pouring its stream of light and energy into your physical heart to sustain your outer consciousness and give you the use of intelligence, emotional feeling, power of thought, memory, and power of physical action. Your presence and mine are not limited in any way. Your presence and mine are one in action, in glorious perfection, and that presence, which is all-knowing, is capable of instantly directing from itself a million or a billion rays of transcendent blazing light into whatever condition, place, or person requires assistance. Therefore, can you not, with all humility, realize that the outer self, as Jesus said, is nothing? Will you not raise your deep and sincere attention to that presence and make it feel that, for once, you desire to work consciously with it again? Then that presence will turn its attention to you, the stream of light, your silver cord, will permanently widen, and your capacity to serve will increase by that renewed partnership. From the heart of that presence, then, you can direct those mighty rays of intelligent light, within which is the violet flame of transmutation, for all of the life everywhere, which you ever may have injured, or which may have injured you, from the time that the shadows of human creation first began to fall upon this dear earth. Do you know that your presence can locate in the ascension temples, or in any realm, wherever they are now abiding, any life stream which you may have harmed at some time, whether they are in embodiment here now or not? That presence can and will, at your call, gladly balance that debt for you in 1 hour, perhaps in just 1 moment. Incidentally, those of you who have forfeited creatures as pets or are associated with them in other ways, have you ever thought that perhaps you are paying back through them a service to life to balance previous actions? When in the past, in self-righteous and zealous enthusiasm, you offered animals upon sacrificial altars as well as bird and human life? Oh, there is much that you do not know. Fortunately, there is a veil of mercy between the conscious mind and etheric memories, and that veil is drawn apart very slowly from time to time, because a quite sane man has been known to go completely mad just by looking upon the dweller on the threshold, as a human creation of his own life stream is sometimes called. There is again the balance. It is really a razor's edge. On the one hand, we have the complacent type of individual who feels that everything will come out all right, and there's no need to do anything about it. Then we have the over-tense one, so eager and desirous of rendering the service, whether it be individual, planetary, or cosmic, that he becomes so tense that the vibratory action of the presence cannot flow through him. There is a great balance and relaxation in a complete alertness to the reality of that presence, to the reality of ourselves, and to the capacity of the presence or ourselves to act through the causal body, directing our radiation and blessing at your call. In my life as Francis Bacon, I had come upon certain understanding of the law of re-embodiment, which interested me deeply. I was a great reader, and during the various temporary incarcerations in that embodiment, I had much time at my disposal. I became interested in the idea of my own past embodiments, and as I read about certain historical characters, they deeply touched me etherically. Feeling that perhaps I had some connection with these life streams in the past, I began to practice releasing the power of the presence to pay whatever personal debts I might owe to those life streams, even though I could not tell where they were abiding at the moment, whether they were disembodied or in embodiment or in the compound, whether they were awaiting embodiment in the Sacred Heart Temple or whether they were my next-door neighbours. That was not important. One day, however, before my ascension, while in deep contemplation of the presence and its violet fire of mercy, forgiveness, and transmutation, my inner sight was opened, and I had a glimpse of a farmer walking through a field, sowing seed. This man was heavy-hearted, and his head was bowed. Suddenly I saw a light ray from my presence go forth, within which was the violet fire. It blazed around that individual, instantly transmuting the cause of his distress, for which cause I had been responsible at one time or another. Thus was paid the particular debt which I owed that life stream. Then that individual raised his head, free of that burden, and actually ran laughing toward the farmhouse. Now that person never knew from whence his release came. I did not even know the name of that man, but I knew his burden was lightened, and that at least some of my karmic debt had been paid. Interesting, if you care to develop it. Balance required between all extremes. There are many aspects and uses of the great law which are interesting if one cares to think about and develop them. One must always remember to stay within the balance between indifference and over-conscientiousness, between pliability and stability, between every extreme which I could continue to elaborate upon, between overconfidence and self-depreciation, between personal dignity and pride, between humility and self-abasement. That balance is really a razor's edge. The natural dignity of embodied men and women who truly represent freedom is expressed by their words, their works, and their lives, and by their walking humbly with their God. It is always joyous for me when I am given opportunity to speak to you, even briefly, and it is a happy and rewarding time for you too, because when I come closer than ordinary to you like this, I bring within the radiance of my being and into your atmosphere and world a much greater concentrate of that sacred fire of mercy which I have loved and served so long. I have always said, you know, and wrote it into the plays which seemed to please the people, as Shakespeare, that the quality of mercy is not strained. Mercy is so magnificent. If every man, woman, and child, animal and elemental, had to balance every jot and tittle of human mistakes, this world task of purification and freedom would take an eternity. Beloved Sanat Kumara then could not possibly have gained his freedom at this time, and there would have been really only one solution to the problem, the dissolving of the entire planet. But the mercy of the Eternal is always waiting for you to call it into action, thus utilizing its powers. It is also waiting for you to make your calls through the use of decrees which have been given to you. If you will stay with them, they will give you within yourself all the proof you will ever need of the efficacy of the violet fire's power called forth. This will mean more to you than all the riches of all the world. You see, when you have gained the power to consciously and instantly sublimate and transmute imperfection into perfection, life will not be long enough for you. You will scarcely want to go home when the call comes. It takes alertness of the mental body, as well as common sense and reason, and it takes your personal interest in the application of the law to bring it into outer manifestation for you. Look at the interest that Edison took in the study of electricity and the hours and months and years which he spent in just learning to harness its power. Is that of much permanent importance to this planet as the violet fire of mercy and compassion, which can be called forth to transmute human shadows into light, sickness into health, financial lack into abundance, and so on? Oh, that you would let me stir into action that wellspring of enthusiasm which is buried deep within you for the reality and efficacy of the use of the violet fire. When our beloved Jesus said to those who came to him for help, "Thy sins are forgiven thee," he used his miracle-producing violet flame. And as the people saw its instantaneous action through his works, there was stirred up some enthusiasm for the use of the violet fire. But that was only a temporary accomplishment. There were only 20 or 30 people from the entire known world at that time who had only a half interest in his mission. Later, beloved Mary only had 40. So you see, we are not doing too badly with the numbers we have now, even though it seems at times as though we do not expand as rapidly as I certainly want us to, and as you in your hearts do too. Prepare now for service to come. Now there is this question of readiness again, and the beloved Mahachahan has asked me to speak to you briefly concerning this. It is a most important subject, and one which I think perhaps you should seriously consider in some of your free moments. You never know ahead of time just when you will be called, or to what post. I will tell you this much, that, as a matter of law, you will always be put in a position of the individual whose endeavours you have criticised. Therefore, it is wise to desist from criticising another life stream, for, should you find yourself in his place, you might not be quite as comfortable as you were in your own, nor be as productive there as you were then, nor be as productive there as you were when from your own place you watched with folded arms the errors of your predecessor, which errors then seemed so obvious to you. But in a lighter vein, be ready at a moment's notice for any summons to service which might come is most important. It is something which has been brought to our attention recently. None of us knew that at the very moment when beloved Moria's petition was granted by Helios and Vesta for the opportunity to start our new activity, Lord Buddha then began to prepare himself by expanding his causal body until it was the same size and perfection as that of Sanatkumara, with the same outpouring of love and power. As we told you, at the time of the transferring of the title and the powers of the Lord of the World from Sanatkumara to Buddha, their two causal bodies coming together were like two exact halves of an orange. The radiation was the same. Now Lord Buddha did that without being told. He did it without being asked, all on his own, as we say. So did the beloved Lord Maitreya prepare himself to take up the office of the new Buddha. Beloved ones, when we speak so to you, it is not to engender any fear. It is not to make you feel tense in any way, so that the presence cannot even get 5% of its energy through to you. No, we speak thus to you in order that you may be better prepared for your service which lies ahead. For you do not know where or when you will be called. Beloved Almora has mentioned this to you several times. He spoke of you being ready to go to far-off places like Tibet, for instance, to render some service which you could give there. Are you ready, financially, physically, etherically, mentally, and emotionally? Are your affairs in order? Are you so pliable that you could go in perfect happiness, just in the garments which you are wearing now, and live in all sorts of inconvenience? Think about this. Now today I bring you not only the benediction of myself, but also that of the beloved Goddess of Liberty, whose focus is established in the harbour of New York, who has chosen to welcome here from every land all those who have need of her assistance. Will you remember that, at the time of my own ascension, the very first being I met in that octave was the same Goddess of Liberty? Speaking to her then, I asked her if she knew from whom I might get more help for those of you whom I had left behind. She assured me that there was such a one, and later I found that she was speaking of her dear self. Since that time, she has most lovingly and graciously given all of us that help. Thank you and good morning, Saint Germain.
Okay, oh, profound words from beloved Saint Germain. Now we've got beloved Terry going to read Dwarkul's New Year address. Thank you so much, beloved Terry. Let me quickly swap this.
Thank you. Those are profound words. Thank you so much. Wonderful reminders. Greetings, everyone. Dwarkul, New Year address, compassionate love. From Shamballa, Long Island, New York, January 7th, 1985. In the true feeling of compassionate love, I greet you. I wish to speak particularly about wisdom. You have learned much about illumination, but it is imperative that you dispense that gift with loving wisdom. And in that feeling, the radiation of loving wisdom, shall all humankind feel the embrace of the blessing of love divine. Remember daily, let it be in the forefront of your consciousness, that compassionate love is a true healer, a purifying agent of the Almighty. You've done exceedingly well this past year, and we look forward with great anticipation to your cooperation in this coming year of love divine, compassionate love divine. Love takes many forms, but compassionate love is feeling from the great heart of I am. You have been told time and time again that love is all there is, and truly having entered into that feeling, that glorious feeling of compassionate love, you will attain the goal set for you in this new cycle. And every month, as the various foci are open to you, remember that each is a center of compassionate love. Understand that everything you say, think, and feel goes forth as an unction to all life. Feel, oh, feel the mighty compassionate love which is enfolding you at this very moment. And as you feel it, see the many hands of the Amida Buddha reaching out and gathering all the nations of the world into the heart of the I am, in the oneness of being, compassionate love. Mighty beings are gracing you with their presence this year. When one speaks, all send forth their love. We are anticipating mighty accomplishments this year, not only in our chelas, but in all life upon this sweet planet, beautiful planet of love, enfolded in the mighty compassionate love of Amida Buddha, the Buddha of limitless light. I counsel you to be very careful how you speak, how you feel when you use the word love. Remember the sacredness of the word love. It has been misused through the centuries. Now you are ready to experience what compassionate love means. Feel that love as a mighty canopy over this entire planet, making her shine forth in all her beauty. And as the hands of all nations are touching one with another, blending as one, feel the embrace of all the planets in this system as one great heart of love. Compassionate love. I wish to impress upon you one thought. I have said it once and I will say it again. You are here in all your activities to express compassionate love and redeem this sweet, sweet earth. I bow to you, the light in all life, and I bless you with all the love of my being. Accept that blessing. Be messengers to all life. And know without a trace of doubt that you are ambassadors of love, ambassadors of the high vibration of our Lord Saint Germain, Amida Buddha. Thank you. DWAL call.
Thank you, beloved Terry. So beautifully read. And oh my gosh, such a lovely, it's such an important thing because I do feel, I'm not sure how all of you feel, but I think we're going into a year of great change and that, we really need to be ready and to express this compassionate love. And I think Amida Buddha is what the Japanese and the Eastern people might use when they're referring to Saint Germain. I was trying to get a little bit of more understanding of it, but I think that is the case, but I'm not 100% sure. Anyway, it's just... We're just going to carry on now because, and then we've got a lovely one, which actually Roxanne sent through in sort of combining all Dang Zan with the animals. So it's lovely. But now we're going to swap over. And this was the gem that I found today. So it's from beloved cosmic angel of unity, Mika. And we know that's our beloved Jesus. From Bridge to Freedom, Bridge to Spiritual Freedom, from what used to be the Path of the Middle Way. And so he says, you may often notice how any disastrous event, painful though it may be, serves as an avenue to draw people together. What those of us in the ascended realms want to develop is the ability for humankind to step above the use of anything negative to create the atmosphere where people step beyond the barriers they have created, which separates you one from the other. During the process of uniting as one, be it a family, a neighborhood, or an entire nation, all anger and fear must be released into the violet consuming flame until the cause and core of every difference every opposing view and every conflict that created each situation is purified once again, so that this will no longer have any effect upon the relationship. Beloved ones, humankind must rise above the human desire to use power to dominate and control others. Rather, you must do everything within your abilities to bring people together, uniting in the loving concern of the needs of others. Until all men and women on the earth and their children can be free from fear and insecurity, there can and will be no lasting peace and unity on your planet. There is such an important lesson, life lesson, sorry, that must be acknowledged, understood, and implemented. Nothing less is acceptable in the grand scheme of all things. So there we know how very, very important our decrees are daily, and our feeling of that violet flame going forth doing its perfect work. And now we've got this wonderful opportunity. We're going to say this decree for all our brothers and sisters that have left their physical bodies and are caught in the psychic and astral realm. So we say together, beloved presence of God, I am in me, and beloved immortal threefold flame of eternal truth within my heart, and beloved Saint Germain, while my body sleeps this night, let all the constructive energy of my entire life stream, including that in my causal body, be used to render whatever service is needed in the violet flame temples established in the psychic and astral realms to draw the full gathered cosmic momentum of the violet purifying flame of divine love and compassion through every discarnate life stream there. Let all the souls who dwell in those realms be drawn into those purifying temples of mercy and compassion, and there have the accumulated destructively qualified energies of their life streams purified and transmuted, so that when they are summoned for re-embodiment by the lords of karma, they bring into incarnation only a heritage of perfection and carry in their life streams no miscreations that would add to their own or the world's distress. We accept this done now with full cosmic power, and so be it, beloved I am, and we thank you. Thank you, thank you for this opportunity. Now we're going to listen to this wonderful video that Roxanne sent through. I just want to say we mustn't forget that compassion is very different to sympathy. So my understanding, compassion is really actually assisting in some constructive way. So even our calls are very much part of construction in a constructive way. So we're going to listen now.
For all and sun,
That's a lovely, lovely video, that, and a beautiful voice. My goodness, what a real gift to the world. All right, so now we're going to say this decree for our beloved animal friends, always remembering the insects and all the reptiles, all that beloved animal and that part of the kingdom. So we just say this now together. Beloved, I am presence of all mankind. Charge your mighty light of mercy and compassion to flow through us all and bring comfort to the animal kingdom. May each human being remember and accept their responsibility as guardians and protectors of this planet's pure and innocent life until all is set free and their divine plans fulfilled. We so decree it and so be it. In God's most holy name, I am. We accept it done and we thank you. Thank you, thank you. Now I'm going to read from beloved God Lemore. We might go slightly over time. I'm sorry about this, everybody. Not too badly, but a little bit. So I'm going to read. This is lovely from beloved God Lemore from Friendship with the Gods. And he says, and we know he's from the Temple of Harmony. When man can realize that the conditions of an imperfect nature that he sees rampant on the earth are the result of what he has done with his energy through the ages, that the emotional outbursts disturb not only him, but those around him, he comes to a realization that all the water element, the emotional sea of energy, is affected everywhere. As you are listening to my advice, I humbly counsel you not to let this be a transitory feeling within you. It is time all learn the lesson that every action, thought, word, or deed affects all life. If man could realize what he tunes into every time he has an emotional outburst, an imperfect or negative thought, he is delaying the activity of redemption, which must take place before the element is returned to its original intent. Sometimes when that energy returns to the sender, it is like an avalanche if it has not been transmuted before it joins its kind. One must be alert at all times to prevent himself from tying into discord within himself or another. Use the flame of purification and transmutation so that the energy which is not qualified with perfection becomes immediately captive in the flame of redemption, and then the sacred fire can do its perfect work without the reaction to the one who is redeeming his energy. Let the tides of energy which flow through your being ever be qualified with the flame of harmony. Then the riptides still pulsating in and around the earth will not affect the service which you came to earth to render. Think often of the words in the song, "River of my life, dear, flow on. Gently flow on, carrying only his cargo." What a magnificent expression which should become a part of your daily living. And now we're going to sing. It's just lovely, and you can put your heart and soul into it, I hope. All Hail to Light. It's got the same tune, which we know is the New Year tune, which was the song that they were singing when, I forget whether it was Lemuria or Atlantis, but I think it was Atlantis was actually sinking. This is what the priests and priestesses were singing. They were singing Auld Lang Syne. So let's just sing. This is such a beautiful song. And just a reminder that we've still got 2 weeks to go when we've got that mighty cosmic stardust, which doubles or trebles the activity in the higher realms to answer our calls. So it's just a wonderful reminder. I'd just like to lift that in for us to remind us. And beloved Antoinette's going to take over now. Thank you, beloved Anne.
Thank you, Anthea. And such a wonderful, wonderful song, that Hail to Light. Such beautiful words to such a familiar tune. And now at this very, very start of 2024, what an opportunity we have to gather together, all of us, and make these calls for the purification of our earth and the freedom of all life on her. We say together, Mighty I Am Presence, great host of ascended masters, archangels and Elohim, cosmic beings and great cosmic light, come forth now in all your cosmic power. Withdraw and withhold all power from destructive forces and individuals with destructive intent throughout the world right now and forever, whether it is conscious or unconscious. Expose, seize, bind, and render helpless all these sinister forces and their activities until the light has removed them completely and illumine the source so this may never act again, and raise up to positions of power the divinely chosen leaders. Replace all with ascended master consciousness and the divine plan fulfilled. We thank you. Our decree for protection. Beloved mighty I Am Presence, beloved Archangel Michael, and beloved Commander Conrad, continually intensify your protective pillar of pure light substance and Archangel Michael's armor of light through and around me. Charged with your invincible protection, all-powerful and impenetrable. I am invisible. I am invincible. I am invulnerable to anything but thy almighty perfection. I am grateful that we are given whatever added protection is needed. And what we ask for ourselves, we ask for our loved ones and that which is constructive in all mankind and the world. Thank you. And we just take that moment to visualize, to see and feel that impenetrable pillar of light, blue and crystal pillar, surrounding ourselves, our loved ones, all constructive people, places, conditions and things across the face of the earth, all those standing up for truth, justice and freedom. We thank you. Our violet fire decree, this wonderful opportunity that we have to call in that purifying power of the violet flame. We say, Mighty I Am Presence, beloved Saint Germain, and those that minister to the violet flame, come forth now and blaze your cosmic violet fire and cause a mighty victory for all the world to see. I am the law of forgiveness in cosmic action now. I am the victory of the sacred fire in all its cosmic power. Mighty angels descend with your purple wands of fire and strike them into the center of every place where there has been a history of sinister force activity. Transmute and consume it all. Cause, call, record, effect, and memory, and set it all free from that which was never meant to be. Replace it all with ascended master consciousness and the divine plan fulfilled. We thank you.
Thank you.
Our decree for the elementals. I am the light of God that never fails, purifying, loving, thanking, and blessing the great directors of the elemental kingdom and every beloved earth, water, air, and fire elemental for your ceaseless service to me and to all mankind. I am the mighty cosmic light, awakening all mankind to the great intelligence of this kingdom. And so be it, beloved I am, we thank you. In the name of my mighty I am presence, great cosmic beings and great cosmic light, I decree, I am the presence, charging the minds and feelings of everybody in America and the world with Saint Germain's ascended master consciousness and perfection. Right now and forever, I am the presence, blessing, illumining, perfecting, and setting all free in service to the light. Now I decree to beloved mighty victory, liberty, beloved cosmic I am presence, and great goddess of liberty, direct the cosmic light of liberty as of a thousand suns into the cause and core of anything attempting to delay the divine plan of the Great White Brotherhood for the Earth's eternal freedom and release us from all tyranny here and now. We thank you. Our decree for divine justice. I am the most intensified cosmic action of the flame of divine justice blazing throughout the world right now and forever. I am the law. I am the justice. I am the judge. I am the jury. Knowing that I am all powerful, then I know that only divine justice can be done everywhere, here and now. Beloved Lady Portia, ensure divine justice prevails throughout the world, right now and forever. And so be it, and so it is, and it is done. Beloved I am, we thank you. Now before we say this next decree, we call to beloved mighty victory to enfold our entire earth in his luminous presence, to fill us with his full feeling of ascended master victorious accomplishment. We say together, I am the victory of the light. I am the victory of the light. I am the victory of the light. I am the cosmic flame of victory, which reigns supreme everywhere, right now and forever. We accept these calls answered as they are made, according to thy will, with full cosmic power, maintained and doubled each instant of each hour until fully manifest. And so be it, and so it is, and it is done. Beloved I am, we thank you. Now we end off as we always do with that mighty focus on love, the secret love star. We call now to all those ministering to this mighty secret love star, that focus of cosmic divine love from the great central sun, shining in the heavens for this 2000 year period, that supreme light that cannot be requalified with human thoughts or feelings. So by the power of our I am presence, we say to all human creation, all misqualified thoughts, feelings, and actions, you have no power. You have no power. You have no power. Your end has come. And we invoke those pink and golden rays from the secret love star. And we command that they go forth. And that all life on this earth, every man, woman, and child, all elemental life, be bathed in this substance from the secret love star. That substance that pushes out all imperfection, all limitation, all division or disharmony of any kind, and fills each and every one of us, all life on this earth, with feelings of love and adoration, with feelings of peace and harmony, with gratitude and reverence for life, with kindness and tolerance, with charity, with grace and goodwill, with compassionate love, with that feeling of unity, Saint Germain's holy family. Beloved secret love star, make each and every one of us a living sun of pure divine love, radiating centers across the face of the earth of pure divine love. In our own home, our families, our country, and all the nations of the world. And we send our deep love and gratitude to all the beings invoked who maintain and sustain this great focus of love. We thank you, and we thank you for our opportunity to add our light to these calls. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, everybody, and a happy, happy new year.
Marvelous. Thank you so much, beloved Antoinette. Bless you. And now we've got the closing invocation, and I'm just thinking now who would like to do Vita, do you have a screen, beloved? Would you like to read the closing invocation?
I wish that I could, but my visual impairment won't allow that. But thank you for asking.
Oh, sweet. Okay, no problem. Beloved Delia, can you read it, beloved?
Hello. Yes. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Closing. Can you hear me?
Yeah, just a little bit louder.
Okay. The closing invocation. Beloved I Am Presence and beloved Master Kathumi, nourish the seeds planted in my consciousness so that the ideas entrusted to me become manifest flowers of perfect expression in my world and the world of all my fellow men. Beloved Presence of God I Am, pour the light of thy great glory upon my consciousness and nourish the seeds planted by the masters. We thank you.
Thank you, beloved Delia. Bless your heart. And so a moment of deep gratitude for these marvelous teachings and for our many blessings and for our opportunity to serve the light. Thank you, thank you, really. We're truly blessed. And thank you, everybody. And I apologize that we're a little bit over time, but there it is. I'm going to just stop the recording now.